I'm Rody Davis for The Developer Show. This is your weekly update on the coolest developer news from Google. To get us started, Google is hosting a Cloud Learn digital training event for developers, IT professionals, and data practitioners of all career levels on December 8th and 9th at no cost. For those in Europe, the Middle East, and Africa, the event will be on December 9th to 10th. The interactive event's purpose is to help equip more than 40 million people with Google Cloud skills. It'll also include live technical demos, Q&As, career development workshops, covering everything from Google Cloud fundamentals to certification prep. You could check out a full listing of everything to expect at cloudonair.withgoogle.com. Over at Android, the Watch Face Studio from Samsung is revealing its Jetpack Watch Face library. The newly announced developer tool creates watch faces without writing any code. The Kotlin Develop library is also useful for developers with a more fine-tuned control. The release also includes functionality from the Wearable Support Library with new features to support customization on smartwatches and the System Companion app on mobile. If you use the Jetpack library to save your watch face configuration options, the values are synced with the Mobile Companion app. The mobile app will also automatically present those options in an intuitive interface with previews that update real time. A link to all the new features with the library will be in the description box below. All right, circling back to cloud, DataStream, Google Cloud's serverless change data capture and replication service, is now generally available. This allows you to synchronize data across databases, storage systems, and applications reliably with minimal latency. This will also support real-time analytics, database replication, and event-driven architectures. It will also allow you to deliver change streams to Oracle and MySQL databases into Google Cloud services like BigQuery, Cloud SQL, Google Cloud Storage, and Cloud Spanner. And we can't forget about BaselCon 2021. This year's attendees had a chance to interact with the community through a series of a Birds of a Feather sessions with live Q&As. Other sessions included reproducible builds with Bazel, embedded platform testing with remote execution, and Bazelizing a gigantic iOS app, and so much more. Also announced, the updated version of the next-gen multi-language, multi-platform build, Bazel 5.0, which will release soon. It includes a new dependency system called BazelMod. For answers to any of your questions regarding BaselCon 2021, you can reach out to baselcon-planning@google.com. And finally, we wanted to recognize the TensorFlow Contributor Awardees for 2021. Contributors to the TensorFlow PA write code, teach classes, and answer questions on forums. Plus, they organize and host events. This year's categories include the SIG Leadership Award, Active SIG Award, and TensorFlow Forum Award, Diversity Inclusion Award, and so much more. Congrats to all this year's participants. Make sure to check out the link in the post for the full list of this year's awardees. To learn more about all these week's stories, make sure to check the description box below for all the links. Please make sure to like and subscribe, share, and stay safe. I'm Rody for The Developer Show. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week. All right.